Hello dear friends, after a long well-deserved break, we have resumed filming tutorials on simple repairs and maintenance jobs for those who are not afraid to get their hands dirty, saving a lot of money and often doing a better job than many mechanics who may not care about your car as much as you do. In this episode, we will show you how to change the brake pads on a 2018 Opel Insignia Grad Sport equipped with electric parking brakes. The operation is identical to that performed when changing the brake pads on a Volkswagen Passat CC, except that then we also presented the option with a diagnostic tool. I've added the tutorial's link in the description if you want to check it out. Actually, the electric motor on this Opel is the same as the one on the Passat CC. You don't have to worry about manually retracting the adjusting bolt, as it will automatically recalibrate upon the first activation of the parking brake. As you will see, you can change the brake pads even in front of your home without the need of a diagnostic tool, garage pit, and as you will see, not even complex tools. Let's do a quick recap of the tools we need. Of course, the most important tool will be the jack and a jack stand, the car's provided lug nut wrench or a breaker bar with a 70mm socket, a press for the caliper piston which can be replaced with two offset box end wrenches, a T30 Torx for the screws that hold the electric motor to the caliper, an M8 bit to retract the motor's adjusting bolt, a 13mm wrench, and instead of the 15mm used on the CC, we will use a 17mm wrench. To remove all the rust, I recommend using a wire brush, a large file, and a small hammer. For a neat job, we also recommend using some brake cleaner spray and some grease. As we have done with many models, we started by suspending the car using the jack under the control arm and securing the car with a jack stand for safety. Then we removed the upper and lower bolts of the caliper. Wiggle it a bit to retract the piston enough for the caliper to come off the brake pads. To remove the connector from the harness, you need to push back the locking clip and press the upper bracket while pulling the connector. Suspend the caliper somewhere to protect the brake fluid lines. Now we can remove the brake pads. As you can see, they were quite worn. Remove the screws from the electric motor using the Torx key, and then you can easily detach the motor. Using an M8, retract the adjusting bolt by turning clockwise until you can no longer rotate it. Now you can push the caliper piston, and because it is a relatively new car, this was possible even with just two thumbs. If your piston is too rigid, you can use the two offset box end wrenches. Place the gasket in position, and if you find rust, it is best to clean it with a wire brush. We used only a screwdriver to remove the little dirt we found. Apply a little grease to the interior. Now we can fix the motor back onto the caliper. Whenever you change brake pads, it is very important to thoroughly clean the rust off the support bracket. otherwise it could result in faster wear of the brake pads or even extremely annoying sounds. It would also be good to clean the rust off the rotor at this stage. It is ideal to apply copper paste or, if you don't have any, a little grease to the guiding rails. It's time to introduce the new brake pads. The set comes with two metal plates for each pad. One of the plates needs to be glued to the outside surface of the pad and the second one snaps over the first one. To differentiate between the two pads, remember that the inside pad will have these warning plates that will make a characteristic sound when the pads are very worn. This is because, as you know, the inside pads will always wear out before the outside ones due to the operating principle of any caliper, as can be seen in this video. After you neatly clean the support bracket, you can insert the metal retainer clips for the brake pads. Finally, we have reached the installation of the pads, but you will need to have a little patience as it is a tight fit. Don't worry, they only fit the right way, so you can't do it wrong. Clean well with some brake cleaner spray using a rag or a paper towel. Now you need to put the caliper back in place and secure it with the upper and lower bolts using the 13mm and 17mm wrenches. Don't forget to plug the electric connector. Put the wheel back on and we're done on the left side. Obviously, the same operation applies to the right side. And that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it and we look forward to your likes and comments. To reward our effort, all you need to do is subscribe to the channel for free by pressing the subscribe button and watch as many of the other DIY tutorials on this channel as possible. Bye-bye!